What you don't know about business. If you're an entrepreneur just getting started years 1 through 5 and you're struggling, you're sucking wind, you're trying to figure out cash flow, you're trying to figure out who you need to hire, you're doing product and development, how to improve whatever your product or service is, and you're running into all these issues and starting to question whether this is the right business for you, here's what I'm going to tell you. It's going to take you several years to be able to unlock your fullest potential in your business. Entrepreneurship's a funny thing. The only way to get through it is by through experience and by through headaches and by through everything that creates a good entrepreneur. There's no avoiding any of it, right? So what you need to start to identify is if you're at the age of, I don't know, 35, 40, 45, the age doesn't matter. I'm 38. So if I was starting at ground zero today, it might take me 4 or 5 years just to unlock 25% of my potential. So let's just say now I'm at the age of 42. It took me 4 years to unlock 25% of my potential. Here's the even better news. It's going to take me half the time to unlock 50%. So now at the age of 44, I've just unlocked 50% of my fullest potential. And then here's the even better news after that. I'm going to be able to double again in half the time. So in 1 year, I'll have grown by 100%. Now I'm talking about me, but I'm also talking about revenue-wise, the money that's coming into the business. So now if it took me 1 year to grow by 100%, then what's going to happen the year after that? I'm going to grow by 200% that next year. And what's going to happen the year after that? I'm going to grow by 400% that next year. And then by 800%, 1600%, and 2400%, right? So we're going to just exponentially start to grow over time. And that's when people start to look at you and like, man, you're getting so lucky. And luck has nothing to do with it because they didn't see you the first 4 years where you were questioning whether you should even be an entrepreneur. Your wife was questioning that you're dumping all your savings into this company. You're not spending any time with the time and with the kids and the family, and you're not going on vacations, and you're not going to birthday parties, and you're coming in early to the office, and you're getting back home late. That's the stuff nobody ever talks about. But I got good news for you. There's a happy ending if you can stick with it, and you can find balance somehow in this crazy chaos of entrepreneurship. You can find the balance to make it work and stick with it and start to network and make all the right connections that you need to make to have people speak life into you, get around mentors, people that have already won, so that way you can stick with it just a little bit longer, because the greatest bet you can ever make is on you. So if you know you've already won, just keep betting on yourself and keep investing in yourself, and you'll win. It's going to take time. It's going to suck. But in the end, there's a happy ending, because this is the best decision I've ever made in my life. I love what I do every day. I come in early. I stay late. I work weekends. I work nights. And I love every fucking second of it. It's amazing. Don't give up.